So I was born and raised in St. Louis, had a wonderful education growing up here with some fantastic mentors in the community who really encouraged me to find a way to make a difference, even when I was young. Went on to Duke University, later to Oxford University, did a master's degree and a PhD there, studying international humanitarian organizations. And then after that, joined the United States Navy SEAL teams. And it was after my last deployment to Iraq, when I came home, that I started the Mission Continues and brought the Mission Continues back to St. Louis. The Mission Continues is a St. Louis-based national nonprofit organization that challenges veterans to serve and inspire in communities across America. We know that this generation of veterans that's coming home, that they are assets to our communities. And so what we do is we create fellowships for returning veterans to continue their mission of public service. And I went to Bethesda to the Naval Hospital to visit with some recently returned wounded Marines. You know, you walk into one of those hospital rooms and you're often talking with men and women in their early to mid-20s. And I asked them a little bit about their units. I asked them about their hometowns. I asked them about their deployments. And then when I said, tell me, what do you want to do when you recover? Every single one of them said to me, I want to return to my unit. They all said, I want to return to my unit. Now, the reality was, for the men and women who I was visiting that day, is that they were not all going to be able to return to their unit. One of them had lost both of his legs, another lost the use of his right arm, part of his right lung, another lost a good part of his hearing. And so I said to each one, I said, well, tell me, if you can't return to your unit right away, tell me what else you'd like to do. And every single one of them told me that they wanted to find a way to continue to serve. One of them said, you know, I had a rough childhood growing up. I'd like to find a way to go home and become a football coach or a mentor. Another one said he was thinking about going back to college to become a teacher. Another one wanted to get involved in law enforcement. We started the Mission Continues by focusing on changing just one life at a time. Our first fellow was Chris Marvin. Chris Marvin was an Army Black Hawk helicopter pilot. He had been serving in Afghanistan, was in a horrible accident, and ended up having severe injuries to his entire body. He became our first Mission Continues Fellow. He went into his barracks and he started serving again, actually with his fellow wounded warriors. He took them out into the community and those wounded warriors started doing service projects in their community. I came home to start the Mission Continues here in St. Louis because I knew that in St. Louis we'd have people who were patriotic, who cared about this generation of veterans, who would come out and they would volunteer and they would serve beside us, and they'd become the people who would invest in our organization and help us to grow, and it's worked. St. Louis has been a fantastic home for us, and now we have a reputation as being the best program in the country for helping veterans to come back and continue their missions of service. In the beginning, for a Mission Continues Fellow, we start with a very simple question. What do you want to do now? How are you going to continue to serve? And after we ask that question, we will then work with the veteran to find a placement for them in the community. At the beginning of that fellowship, they come together at an orientation, and they take, at the end of the orientation, their Mission Continues Fellowship oath. And after they've taken that oath, they return to their community. They go through a 6-month service and leadership program where every day they're in the community being of service. At the end of those 6 months, a successful fellowship leads to full-time employment or full-time education and an ongoing role in service. So many people have said to us, you know, I couldn't serve in Iraq, I couldn't serve in Afghanistan, I was too old, I was too young, it wasn't my time, I had a family, but I want to play my part. And through the Mission Continues, we've had thousands of people come together because we all have a role to play in this fight. This is a battle that we can all participate in, and if we win, then what happens is we have a whole generation that's come home and has made our country stronger.